Welcome back, children. Hi, all of you. So we are now in the fourth session of our online class. So are you all studied? All the three classes over. Now we are in the last section of our first lesson. So have you all finished your all notes? Are you all completed your notes and worksheet? Last week onwards, I am giving you the textbook exercises as the worksheet. So you have to do it in the notebook itself. That is, I am giving you the notes that is attached to the video, and I think all of you are written the notebooks and notes all are finished. Then after the notes, you have to do the textbook exercises as the worksheet. So what we learned last class, what we learned? We studied how to form a four digit number, greatest and smallest, by the given digits. How to make a four digit number, that is, it is greatest and smallest. So now we reached the end of that chapter. So last class we studied forming the greatest and the smallest number using the four digits. So how will we make a greatest and smallest number? How will we form the greatest number using the given digit? Suppose we will take the number 4, 7, 3 and 5. So how will we make the number greatest number using this digit? So from the given numbers, I gave you number 4, 7, 3 and 5. So how will we make the greatest number using these digits? The greatest number in these digits is 7. 7 is the greatest number. 4, 7, 3, 5. So we will write first as 7. Then which number we will write? We will write the number 5. Next number is 5. Then which number we will write? 4. Then last we will write the number 3. So how will we read this number? So we got the four digit greatest four digit number. So how will we read this number? 7543. 7543. Then how will we make the smallest number using these digits? So it is also very easy. We already formed the greatest number using these given digits. So it is very easy to make the smallest number. So which is the smallest number among these given digits? 3 is the smallest number. So we will write first as 3. Then which we will write? 4. Then which we will write? 5. Then last we will write the greatest digit, that is here 7. So we formed the smallest number. Then how will we read this number? 3457. 3457. So by the given digits, we formed the greatest and smallest four digit number. So this we studied in the previous class. So I think that all are understood how to form the greatest and smallest number using the given digits. So now we will reach to the end of this chapter, and only one portion left to study. So let us start the class. So now we are going to study odd and even numbers. Odd and even numbers. What do you mean by an odd number? And what do you mean by an even number? Odd number, that is, here I am writing some digits. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So what do you mean by odd numbers? Odd numbers are the numbers when its ones place are these numbers. These numbers. When the we will take a four digit number, 4329. So how will we identify this is an odd or even number? How will we identify if 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, any one of this number will came in the ones place? If any one of this number came in the ones place, it that number is called an odd number. That number is called an odd number. So here the numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. If any one of this number can be in the ones place, When it will be in the ones place, the number is called odd number. That number is called odd number. So, how will we identify an odd number? If 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. If any one of this number came in the ones place, this is the ones place. Ones place. If any one of this number came in the ones place, that number we are calling as an odd number. So, what do you mean by odd number? If in the ones place, if we are given a number like this 4-digit number, then how will we identify it is an odd number? If 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 is in the ones place, any one of this number is in the ones place, it is called as an odd number. So, then how will we identify a number is an even number? That also we will look. So, what do you mean by an even number? We studied how will we identify an odd number. That is in the ones place, if in the ones place there is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, that number is calling as an odd number. So, how will we identify the number is an even number? If 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. If these numbers are in the ones place of a number, that numbers we are calling as an even number. So, what are the numbers? 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. These are the numbers. If any one of these numbers came in the ones place of a 4-digit number, that number we are calling as an even number. So, we will look. 2378. This is a 4-digit number. And this is, what is the number in the ones place? In this number, what is the number in the ones place? The number is 8. Here the number is 8. So, this is an even number. Even number. So, this is also a even number because the ones place, the number is 8. 8 when 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Any one of this number came in the ones place of a number, we will call the number as even number. So, here the number, I taken the number 2378. How will we read this number? 2378. That number we are calling as even number because the ones place of this number is 8. Ones place of this number is 8. So, we call this number as an even number. So, now we will look some examples of odd and even and how to identify the number is an odd or an even number. So, now we will look how to find an even number or an odd number. How to find a 4-digit number is an even or it is an odd number. So, first example here, I wrote the number 4026. How will we read the number? 4026. So, we have to look the ones place. If the ones place number is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, that number we are calling as an odd number. If the ones place number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, that number we are calling as an even number. So, now we will find which is odd, which is even. So, here the first number is 4026. What is in the ones place? The number is 6. Ones place number is here 6. So, the number is even or odd? Which is the number? It is an even number. It is an even number because the ones place number is here 6. 6 is in the ones place. So, next one. 3271. 3000. Next number is 3271. Which is the number in the ones place here? Here the ones place number is 1. So, this number is which number? This number is which number? It is an odd number because the ones place number is here 1. When 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 came in the ones place, that type of number we are calling as an odd number. So, it is also an odd number. Then next number is 4963. 4963. So, Which type of number is? It is odd or even? How will we identify? By looking the ones place. By looking the ones place. Ones place the number is here 3. Ones place the number is here 3. So which type of number is that? It is an odd number because it is ones place the number is here 3. It is an odd number. Odd number. The next number is 6286. 6286. Which type of number is this? Here, ones place number is here 6. So it is an even number. It is an even number. Then next number is 7349. 7349. Then which type of number is that? The ones place number is here 9. Ones place number is here 9. So which type of number is that? It is an odd number. It is an odd number. Then last, at last the question is, the number is 8240. 8240. So tell me which type of number is that? It is an even number because the ones place number is here. Which is the ones place number is here? 0. 0 is a ones place number is here 0. So if 0 came in the ones place, that number is also we calling as an even number. So we a given set of numbers, we identify which are even, which numbers are even and which numbers are odd. So I think all are understood how to find an even or an odd number. Odd number, the ones place, the numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. And even number, the ones place numbers are 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. So, I think all are understood how to find the even number and the odd number. So, next our session, our last session of this chapter is predecessor and successor. Predecessor and successor. How will we read this? Predecessor and successor. So, what do you mean by predecessor and what do you mean by successor? It is very simple. We already know the other name of this predecessor and the successor. It is not only this predecessor. Are you all familiar with this name predecessor and successor? No. Are you all familiar with the term before and after number? Yes, is it clear now? Now, before number, what we are calling before number is the predecessor. That is the other name of before number, predecessor. And successor, we are calling the after number as the successor. After number and before number, that we know, that we already studied in first and second standard. The other names, the another name for before number and after number is predecessor and successor. You don't worry about the name predecessor and successor. It is only before number and after number. So, now we are here dealing with the 4-digit number. So, look how to find the predecessor and the successor. Predecessor means the before number. Predecessor means the before number and successor is the after number. Predecessor is the before number. Predecessor, the before number. And the successor is the after number. Before number is the number that comes just before a number. And successor, that is after number, is the number that comes after a number. That comes the next number. So I wrote here three numbers. 4124, 4125, 4126. So what is the predecessor of this 4125? What is the number predecessor of this 4125? This is the predecessor of 4125. That is 4124 is the predecessor of 4125. And what is the successor of 4125? 4126 is the successor of 4125. That is, this is the before number and this is the after number of 4125. So now look another example. I wrote here three numbers: 2890, 2891 and 2892. So how will we find the predecessor and successor of this number? predecessor is the before number. I told you predecessor is the before number and successor is the after number. So predecessor 2890. What is the predecessor of 2890 is the predecessor of 2891. And what is the successor of 2891? 2892 is the successor of 2891. So now we studied how to find the predecessor and successor of a number, of a four digit number. Predecessor is not anything, it is the before number of a number, and successor is the after number of a four digit number. We are dealing with the four digit numbers. So predecessor is the before number and successor is the after number of a number. So I think all are understood how to find the predecessor and successor of a four digit number. So here in this chapter, this is the last section. So predecessor and successor, before number and after number of a number. So I think all are understood how to find the predecessor and successor of a four digit number. So in this class we studied how to find an odd number. What do you mean by an odd number and an even number? How to find an odd number and even number? And we also studied the predecessor and the successor of a four digit number. That is, predecessor and successor means the before number and after number of a number. And odd number and even number, that also we studied how to find an odd number and an even number. So I think all are understood these two portions. This is the last section of our first lesson. Next class onwards we are starting the second chapter. That is, second chapter is addition. Addition of four digit numbers. And one more thing. You have to do the worksheet as your exercises. I will give you in the parent day which exercises you have to do. And I will attach the notes in this video. So you have to write the notes. After the notes, you have to write the exercise, that is textbook exercise. I will give you the number and page number of this exercises, and you have to do after this exercise. And you have to do one thing. We already finished this chapter. The first section of this chapter, we didn't write the exercise, the textbook exercise we didn't do. So you have to do that exercise also. You have to do in the textbook itself. If it is if there is no space for doing the problems, don't worry, you have to do in the back side of the notebook. So you don't skip that exercises. You have to do the exercises, and the remaining exercise also you have to do in the notebook or in the textbook. So I think all are understood, and in next class we will take the next chapter. We will start the next lesson, that is the second chapter, addition. So all of you have to study well and take care. Bye-bye.